Well, a very good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Imagine Cruising 2023 World Indoor Bowls Championships live from Potter's Resorts here in Hopton-on-Sea. One more game for you this evening. It's a bit of a local derby. It's Wayne Willgress taking on little Katherine Rednall. So let's have a little look at the match officials. Our marker is Greg Brown. The umpire is Mike Davies. And Sue Mates is on the shot clock. So let's go down to the portable rink and join the hostess with the mostess, Zach Patterson.
Thank you, Jason, for that marvellous introduction. The first player out this evening is a previous World Singles quarter-finalist, a winner of the World Mixed Pairs titles in 2016, and a four-time Ladies World Match Player Champion. Please welcome, from England, Katherine Rednall. Her opponent is a multiple national champion, a quarter-finalist in the World Paris in 2021. He reached the semi-final of the World Singles in 2018. Please welcome from England, the number 14 in the world, it's Wayne Willgress.
I said y'all having a good time out there.
Ladies and gentlemen, your commentators for this evening are Jason Parkinson and Graham Irving Cole.
Well, thank you very much, Zach. Once again, a very good evening to you all. Thank you for joining us here at Potter's Resorts for this Imagine Cruising World Indoor Bowls Championships. Well, an absolutely amazing game on the cards here. It's a local derby, both players from the local area. Wayne Willgress, well, he's the newcomer to the top 16 here at the World Bowls Tour. Katherine Rednall, she managed to secure her place here with a sponsor's choice. Mark Royal is the other sponsor's choice. This could get very interesting indeed. Joining me in the commentary box once again, Graham Irving Cole, all the way from Scotland. Good evening.
Good evening. My penultimate evening.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Get ready tomorrow?
No, I'm going away on Friday afternoon. Oh. What do you mean, oh? It's great to be back again. Looking forward to this game. She's said I think it should be an interesting game. Local rivalry between the two players.
So. Yeah, it's like almost a Suffolk-Norfolk derby, isn't it, in a way? Both players from not too far away from Potter's Resorts here.
How far is my ball, mate, please?
22 inches past Jack A.
Katherine's been on detention duty. She's a school teacher, secondary school. Wayne's a painter and decorator. I think it's going to be who settles down the first in this game. Yeah. It's going to be a lot of local support, which I think is fantastic. Might get a little bit noisy, but as long as they're fair, no problem for that at all.
If you are watching on social media platforms, if you get any questions, just pop them in Facebook chat. And if you are watching on YouTube, just remember and click on the add-on so you're getting views for when YouTube is on with the live games.
Thank you. Martin's off to a great start. What's the pace? Overplayed, so it's going to be a massive opportunity for Wayne. Tell with Wayne's face, he's fired up already. He knows not the pressure, but he knows how good Katherine Rednall is. She's a superb player, but not just a superb player. She's a superb player on this portable rink.
Yeah, yeah.
And I've always said the quicker Wayne gets fired up, the better he plays early on.
I don't think he's here, is he?
Three shots, Wayne Willgress.
A big chance there.
So you can see some of the fans in the audience there. People just drifting
set
in from the evening meal.
After the first end.
Both of these players' families are sat in the audience, slightly different areas. Obviously, Katherine Rednall from a fantastic bowling family. John Rednall, her father, has been around the game an awful long period of time.
24 and a half.
But also at a high level as well, Graham.
Right, okay. Yeah, and it's good that she's followed on that trend and became the player that she has become. Certainly a good height here, just down to pace. Very good reply from Katherine Rednall.
Katherine's choose to play with the famous birds, as we call
it's
them.
It's half the ball,
the
half an inch in front.
Tour.
Jack high.
Set from the pool balls, one of the older sets as well of Henselite Tigers. We call them the birds because obviously they've got a little bird logo as the emblem.
Yeah. Push through it. So Catherine's still sticking with her backhand, just looking to drift in round the front red ball, round to the back of the jack.
One green.
Wasn't far away from pace, maybe just a foot more would have just carried Katherine over the top of that pole.
After that first end, Wayne will be disappointed with the three of his four balls there that he's played.
Just just looking for decent pace. Anywhere within a foot of this, Jack will make a double. Yes, well played, Katherine. Oh, there we have.
This
lady here in the audience, she's been coming for many, many years. A massive supporter of not only just us at World Bowl Store, but also Potters. She wears a nice different colour flower every single day. It was white yesterday.
White yesterday.
Yep. Yeah. Spent a little bit of time with her, had a little soda water. It's nice to see the repeat people coming back to these championships. Someone asking there if Katherine's in all three. Yes, Katherine's obviously in this World Open singles.
Jack Lenz,
mixed pairs. Well, she's got a bit of a bad draw. She's drawn Les to play with. World champion, that's not a bad draw, is it?
No, certainly not.
And then in the ladies' match play championship, Katherine will be playing Claire Hendra from New Zealand. What size bowl is Katherine using? Well, the Tigers are size 4. Which amazes me, really, because she's quite small. As in height-wise, she's got a quite small hand. But that's quite, I mean, I play with a 3. I mean, when you look at Katherine's delivery, I don't know how on earth she holds the bowl. She kind of cups it and just...
Yeah.
Such a smooth delivery.
One red.
Well, working off her own.
One, yeah.
One red. It's 2.5 inches past Jack height.
Oh, well. Good shot from little Katherine there. Such a class player, really is. She's a very calm player as well. You know, even when things are not going quite right or she may be struggling a little bit, she keeps that composure.
Yeah. She has the same expression all the way through.
Yes, yes.
Shot, well played.
Yeah, it's a good draw ball from Wayne.
Set score 4-2 after 3 ends. Jack Lynn's 26 and a half metres.
Just an answer to Rebecca's question. Wayne is playing with his own balls, own aero set of balls, and Katherine is playing with a set of tigers from the pool of balls that World Balls Tour have.
One red. 3 inches short of Jack High. Eighth of an inch, tiny gap. Catherine's gap is 5 inches.
Oh dear.
Here.
As you get down to the bowl of the chat, turns the bowl. Oh, well played.
Time out. Wayne, you have 4 calls remaining.
Wayne has 4 timeouts remaining. Still a draw on either hand available for Katherine. She can just play the open draw or play the backhand down to the red bowl of Wayne Willgress's. Taking them out.
2 shots, Katherine Rednall.
Good 2.
That's a game on square.
Set score 4-4 after 4th end.
Oh,
ball square. And don't forget, we have five more World Open singles for you tomorrow. Same early starting time for those who want to get up early to watch the start. 9:30 in the morning, please. First game on the cards tomorrow is Robert Paxton against the Israeli qualifier of Noam Yehudai. Just slightly over in pace. Good line.
One red.
One red.
How far's mine?
The gap's 12 inches.
Another good ball from Wayne.
Two red.
Oh, Katherine. Oh, well played.
One green.
One Katherine Rednall.
2 inches.
And my back one?
5.5 inches.
Then I'll just be trying to his own back ball here, fall in. Good enough to give him the shot. Wondering whether she might just play down this other hand now, down the blind side there, down to the red ball. She can still play the same ball. She played a very, very good ball. Just that little risk of if she's just slightly overplayed, may just get down to the jack. If she plays the other hand, she can get to the ball, sit off it solid. It's a personal choice as usual.
She's going to give that a go.
Yeah, I thought she I thought she would. It just seems that's a little bit safer.
Yeah, I know Wayne's got the shorter ball there, but she's not going to do any damage with that.
Well, Katherine, is she going to make the trip? Slight wiggle. Oh, well played. Wasn't too far away anyway.
Too green.
Katherine, at the moment, has both the spots covered. Yep, you can see from there. Don't think he can go any worse than two down, should he hit this target. Needs to be quick because the shot clock is ticking away.
Two shots, Katherine Rednall.
Set score 4-6 after five ends.
So Katherine would have taken that score after the first end. Wayne had the chance to draw for four and was short. Katherine at the poor end. Wayne had a really, really good end. But the standard of bowling
Jack length, 27.5 metres.
Really, like really top class today again. A good track here as well.
He's getting back to the jacket. How's done? Great bowls.
Fantastic.
Yeah, two good opening bowls from both of these players. An appreciative crowd here at Potter's Resorts this evening.
Catherine's got a good line again, I would think. She's very close here.
Well. Oh, maybe that slight touch may have just cost her.
One red.
It's still a cracking bowl.
Totally brilliant start to this end. Just a change of hand for Catherine, reach her own bowl, fall in for short.
Well, there is that. I mean, you know, each of the players have their preference. She just adjusts the pace as well. Looks better on the forehand. There's still that little bad result of flicking the jack, but yeah, she can see more of the target.
I've got one right.
Must be a leap year. She just hold up, just finish a little bit more on this hand. Oh, great effort.
One red.
The head, if anything, just sitting slightly better for her now.
Quick question there from Steve Bennett. Are we live on the stream next week? Yes, the stream stays live both on Facebook and also YouTube for the whole World Championships. The BBC join us from next Monday.
Time out call.
They always show the Catherine, World Open Pairs final live with David Corkill and his team. They'll take you through the last week of this championship. The stream's live, but we take their commentary. I'll still be here. So I'll be able to answer some questions if you want to send me some messages or emails. Just overplayed, it's very easy to do down there. You know, you've got 3 seconds, like we say a few times, where you just slightly overplay a ball with a yard or two. It's so, so difficult to just get it back to centre.
So when I'll just be trying the same target here, just reaching Catherine's bowl to fall back in.
Yeah, it just needs to run, I think.
One shot, Wayne Willgress.
So a fabulous first set here from Wayne and Catherine. We always knew this was going to be a fantastic game, and it's certainly not disappointing so far. Just quickly, whilst they're sending the jack, we have a question there from Joshua Bardwell. Josh, what happens if the ball is directly on the re-spot? So if someone plays to cover the re-spot and it sits directly on the re-spot and then the jack is displaced, the jack will go as close to the re-spot as possible, but towards the centre of the rink, but not touching, not touching the ball that's covering the re-spot. Just pulling up a fraction shot.
1.5 inch gap.
Well, if she could just get down to this back red bowl of Wayne's, that would be plan A. She's not far away either. She wants to just probably just get past this bowl. Still finish good. They have a lovely photo of the
one
Rednall family. Far left
second.
There's John Rednall. That's Catherine's father. Catherine's gran in the middle there with the blue puffer jacket. And then her mum on the far side. All fantastic players in their own right. It's great to see three generations, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. And it's good that they've all had that standard of bowling.
Correct.
You know.
Good second,
one
I think.
Green.
Second shot.
Yep.
We've been asked, Jason, who are the commentators tipping to win this match?
Ho, unfair. Unfair. Is that Steve Broom? I thought it would be, yeah. In any sport, I love an underdog, me.
Well, my honest answer would be, Wayne is a fantastic drawer. He's a fantastic runner of a ball. But I think you sort of, touched on it earlier on about Catherine being calm throughout.
Yeah.
You know, and that's what they're playing for.
Wayne, three calls remaining.
Trophy for the World Bowls singles.
The angles. Oh, well played.
Superb ball by Wayne Willgress.
Three shots, Wayne Willgress.
Set score 8-6 after 7 ends.
Just a reply to Brian's question there. Yeah, we take the commentary. We still do live streaming. We'll take the commentary from BBC through the Facebook and YouTube channel.
Jack length, 26 metres.
Someone saying there, why do we comment on all the bowls, line and length, saying we spoil what's going to happen? Well, we need to understand that we have an awful lot of players that follow the sport, not only new, so we have to look after new players to the sport because the sport needs new players, but we also have an awful lot of visually impaired players that are tuning in as well. So we have to just try and help the visually impaired players as well, build a form of a picture, if you wish, or build the head up in their mind so they can follow the game as well. So, you know, I won't apologise for kind of like giving a running commentary, if you wish, but we have to understand there's more than the able-eyed person that's that watching
absolutely.
The game. So just please understand that as well.
Joe Patola is asking how long it takes to set up the venue. It takes approximately a day and a half to get the stands in and the portable rink up and running, and then it takes a day and a half to take it all back down again.
One green.
Ball from Wayne.
One red.
Katherine just looking to be inside or turn their own ball here. Slightly over. Going to a good place.
Three. Five off ball. The gap is 5 inches.
Well, there we have a great shot of Wayne's family there in the blue and red striped top. That's Wayne's father. He's a great county player in his own right. Just behind him, there's one of the Segalos. There's a Segalo brothers. I'm not quite sure which one it is, to be honest. But yeah, they're great players. Wayne also has a brother that plays bowls. Well, used to play bowls. I've not seen him for a while. At a great
time
standard as well, Jake. So both of these are playing, you know, from a bowls family, which is lovely to see. Oh, unlucky, Katherine.
One shot, Wayne Willgress.
Yeah.
Set score 9-6 after 8 ends.
So that big takeout shot from Wayne is proving to be very vital in this first set.
Back length 26 metres.
Someone just pulling me there, Ian Finch, just about what I said about the tee, saying that I've said it incorrect. Nope, we're the World Bowls Tour. We have our own rules. I know World Bowls say when the jack is the re-spot is covered, the jack goes up the rink. We don't do that. We play from the re-spot towards the other re-spot, directly in line, as close to the re-spot as possible, but it won't be touching the nearest ball that's covering the spot. Thank you.
Fantastic opening by Wayne Willgress. Start of this ninth end of the first set, final end here.
Yeah, one green.
What's the gap on the last ball?
Gap on the last ball, 5 inches. One green.
Oh, well played, Katherine. Oh, there we have the two Jamies, both of them looking on here, maybe for maybe a little bit of tactical advice. We'll see how the rink's playing. On the right there, Jamie Chesney, and on the left, Jamie Walker. Well, Wayne, just not getting back in time. Well, Katherine, massive opportunity here. Just needs to slot this one in for three and then put Wayne under a massive amount of pressure. It's not a massive target. Can she just stop in time?
Very close.
Oh, well, that may have just cost her. Unlucky there. Good ball. Just sat the wrong side of the back green ball.
Time out call. When two calls remaining.
Two calls remaining from Wayne. It's obviously not got that unlimited package with O2. So he'll be looking at getting down to this wall of bowls just past the jack. So how's the pace, Graham? Will it reach?
Pulling up short, I think.
And a fall away.
Yeah.
So a huge opportunity for Katherine. Draw available on either hand, I'd say there. Needs to get this three for a tied set.
So Katherine knows that if she just reaches her own last ball here.
Time out, please.
She won't be far away
Katherine,
from the third shot that she's looking for. good height. Wayne's clapping the ball coming up.
So not far away, is it? Can it run? Needs to run. Oh, not quite sure, Graham.
I think
I don't know whether she's been just unlucky there, you know, with those last two balls. Not quite sure. It's a big ball, really, isn't it? Let's ask them the ball, having a look.
What do you want?
So they're just measuring there. A quick question asking why we don't invite the English singles winner. Well, our organisation, we're a professional organisation. We're the World Bowls Tour. We have the Professional Bowling Association, a part of that. So we have like a qualifying school, not just here in the UK, but in all the countries around the world that have PBA branches. People pay to be a part of those branches to qualify. So if you're qualifying in maybe three or four different events, and we just invite someone who isn't a part of the PBA or the World Bowls Tour, I don't think that looks particularly good. We have invites for certain events. We do have invitational competitions. But I just wanted to give a quick answer to the question. Let's have a look at this. This is going to be interesting. I just favoured the red, but I'm not quite sure.
When I see it.
No, it's red. I'm going to go red.
Yeah.
Unlucky.
So, Wayne Willgress takes his
first two shots, Katherine Rednall.
9 shots to 8. Katherine Rednall, very unlucky with her last two deliveries of that end.
First set, Wayne Willgress.
So once again, thanks for joining us down here at Potter's Resorts once again for this World Indoor Bowls Championships. We've got a brand new sponsor on board this year, which is great to have. And we're going to have a quick look at why Imagine Cruising is more than just a cruise. Just a little glimpse at some of the packages that Imagine Cruising have to offer. They're an exclusive and luxury global tour operator with offices in the UK, Australia, New Zealand and South Africa. They specialise in once-in-a-lifetime holidays, also cruises all across the globe, individually created by experts that are based in the location that you want to travel to. So have a look at their website, imaginecruising.co.uk. Back to this one then. Well, this match is failing to disappoint.
On red. The gap on both balls, Catherine's ball, it's 18 inches in front of Jack High.
Very close here.
Yeah, top side with good pace, well played.
One green.
So another chance for Katherine just to slot another one in here. She can play the same line, just drifting around her own bowl. I think if she flicks it just over once, I think that may be enough just to score another shot. Needs to turn
on once, yeah.
Ooh.
Full contact with it.
To measure now.
So although it's not turned the bowl, you find a lot of times on an indoor surface, especially those quick
measure
indoor surfaces when the carpet's pretty stretched, even though you rock a bowl with a sticker, sometimes it just tends to skid,
yeah,
maybe 2 or 3 millimetres. Nearly played this, you know, Graham.
Yes, it's very
brilliant.
Well,
brilliant. Oh, no. Dear me.
One. Yep.
One shot, Katherine Rednall.
Set score 0-1 after the first end. Jack, 25 metres.
About 18 inches short. Good line here, just all down to eight.
Yeah, the ball, perfect pace.
Two red.
Good enough for second shot.
Catherine,
one red. Pleased with that.
My ball relation to Jack High, please.
Your ball is Jack High.
Well, Wayne. Can it just sneak in for another? Needs to run a foot. Just given up. Great line.
One red.
Catherine, very close to this, Jason.
Oh, yeah. Oh. She's been a little unlucky there. I mean, she's got... Look at those three balls there that have gone down that back corner. Not sure who's in, but I think she should have got a slightly better result than that, but still a good hit. Tremendous bowl, yeah.
Two shots, Wayne Willgress.
Set scored 2-1 after two ends. Jack Bennett, 29 metres.
Good start here, I think.
Yep, just a foot of running short, I think. Still not bad. Almost a full length jack, which is 29.5 metres on this portable ring.
That line just a fraction longer.
Measure all round.
Could it be two down?
No. I favour this ball is shot. Your second.
Well, quite close all round is what Greg Brown's saying. It seems to be that he favours Katherine, let's say.
Yeah, the last ball. I favoured it as well, but my predictions today have been...
Dreadful.
Dreadful. Yeah. Yep, the shot now. Yep. That'll be the shot.
I'd say so, yeah.
I can say that with confidence.
I mean, both of those wing bowls are almost just on the line. I mean, if she sits her own, she should be enough for shot. Just needs to run, though.
Two, I think.
I disagree, I'm a runner.
Greg says he favours two.
Catherine, Catherine says she disagrees.
I mean, there's a few different options in there. I mean, it's she could play a really good ball, but land in the back of the red ball, which will get nothing. I don't know whether she may just take a bit of a chance here, yeah, playing quick down the back, and if she gets the jack full or slightly off centre, could she make a two or three?
Sticking to the draw, thank you.
She'll just be guaranteeing that she arrives in that head. There's she loads to work off.
Yeah, if you say if she...
Oh, she shot. A shot.
Right.
No, you can have one. But I'm pretty certain it's only one.
I think it's only. Can we have a measure?
She's a feisty one.
She is, yeah. I can see everybody getting put in detention.
Yeah. Oh, they'll be in detention, yeah. She had 39 in detention, she said, for second school. That's,
did she?
I don't know whether I'm just old. That seems a lot in detention.
A lot. A lot of naughty students. That one there's certainly not in it.
West of your league.
And neither is that one. One shot to Wayne Willgress.
She was right.
She was right.
One shot, Wayne Willgress.
Once again, thank you all for joining us this evening. Just over 8,000 viewers at any one time. Just looking at the stream. If you are on the YouTube, please just click the subscribe button. You'll be notified of all the live games when they're about to start, etc. But it also helps us just promote the sport when we're going to various sponsors, etc. Broadcasters, just to have that bigger subscriber list, if you wish. So if you want to help develop the sport and to see more events, just click that button. It just takes a few seconds.
Good open up from Wayne. The answer to today's competition. David Gourley, how many games has David Gourley played in the World Bowls Tour? Was 220, including today's game.
Yeah, and today's competition was held on both YouTube and Facebook. We've been alternating in the last couple. We've done both streams. We have the little comments up if you wish. Yeah, the Facebook crowd just beat the YouTube. Not that I want to segregate them, but Facebook just beat you today. He's talking to that. Didn't like it. Don't think it's too bad if it just runs.
Fraction high, just a fraction short as well.
Comment there from Barry. Sorry, I have seen it. I'm just trying to work my way through the questions without boring you to tears. World Bowls Tour events, obviously we had the Scottish just a couple of months ago.
One red.
We had the UK Open back in April. Next one, hopefully, will be announced in the next week or two. Just need to do some little bits of finishing things off, if you wish. Making sure it's all a done deal. We'll let you know. I'll play Wayne.
Side of that ball.
Two red.
didn't want to hit it too hard. Well played. Surely Catherine's got to arrive down the forehand there.
Three red.
Sit those two balls, get to the jack. Don't want to chase it too much because it will just stick away. Just nice full draw into the pack. Well, Catherine wants to bend a bit more. Well played.
Some top class bowling being played in this game.
Certainly is.
One shot, Catherine Rednall.
It's interesting to note there, I mentioned about subscribing on the YouTube, and I noticed my bowls mother, as I call her, Joyce Jones, there in Rochdale. Doesn't cost you anything to subscribe on YouTube, that's really important, and thanks for pointing that out. We'll at World Bowls Tour, we never ask you for any money, even that, you know, we've given you 135 hours of free streaming, we will never ask you for money. So if there is a site out there, we do get them, unfortunately, asking you to subscribe and asking you for your credit card, please don't.
Jack Lenz, 26 metres.
Well, Catherine, nice and solid. Oh, unlucky. Great effort.
Gap's now 4 inches.
Four?
Four, yeah.
Line's good. How goes the pace?
Over, I think. Catherine's got a good line here as well.
She nearly played this. Oh, brilliant.
Certainly won't give this up without a fight.
One green.
Oh gosh, no. Certainly got a lot of fight in her.
Down to pace from there for Wayne. Fantastic effort.
I mean, she's just played the backhand, but I just feel she may just change to the forehand. The line is obviously there because her ball's finished where it has done.
Reminded up, Jason.
Come on. Well, going for the bowler, the jack is underneath. What kind of result is he getting? A bad one.
One shot, Katherine Rednall.
So another one for Katherine. Someone's asking what the prize money is for the World Championship. Total prize money is £131,000. I think for bowls that's absolutely exceptional. Winner of this World Open singles will receive £50,000 first prize. Thanks for the question.
Jack length 25 metres.
Willgress.
Well, Katherine just needs to make it just 18 inches or so short.
Mine's Jack High.
One inch short of Jack High.
Short.
1 inch short.
Yeah, that was the answer to the quiz question today. David Gourlay has the most World Bowl Tour appearances, 220, which includes today's game.
Yep, it's probably because he's been around forever.
Too red.
Closest to David is Paul Foster in the top 16. He's got the second most World Bowl Tour appearances.
Two timeout.
Which is the shot ball, please?
Shot ball, second ball.
And the gap of the shot ball?
Shot ball gap is 3 inches.
Well, Katherine, having a look at this, I think there's only two options available. She either sticks with the backhand, plays down to the wing bowl of Wayne Willgress's, or she can play the forehand, just play down there inside for the jack.
Time out. Time call, please. Katherine, one call remaining.
Lucky there from Katherine. Still one to Wayne.
Time out. Wayne, one call remaining.
question there about saying about David Gourlay getting into the singles back in 96 from David Thomas. Almost correct. David Henry withdrew and Mr. Gourlay got into the UK singles, and off the back of that, getting to the semi-final of that event, gets the invite to the Worlds, where he went ahead and became world champion. Not a bad bit of knowledge, that though, Graham.
I know, thanks.
Not you.
One shot, Wayne Willgress.
Set score 4-3 after six ends. Jack length 28 metres.
Stuff being played from both of these players.
One red.
Far away.
Doesn't like the jackpot.
Ooh, close. Nearly feathered it away. This is a big bowl for Katherine. You know, she just lost the first set. Going into the last two ends, she'll want to try and be almost level or just getting slightly ahead. Give herself a fighting chance for the last couple of ends. Something very similar, she wasn't too far away. Just a very slight adjustment in pace.
She's under here, should I?
One shot, Wayne Willgress.
Set score 5-3 after 7 ends.
So Wayne is two ahead now, with two ends to play. Wayne just holding fire there. You can always tell when it's 9 o'clock.
Jackman, 28 metres.
Can it just get down to the bowl? Yes, it's got the right side.
As if she's well down here again.
Yeah, she's well played. Nice and solid. Fall away. Yeah, well done.
2-3.
We'll play through here, do you think?
Yeah, I think he will play quick. Down again, even if she hits the red ball. See, either she draws there for three, or she goes deeper and covers the back.
Two green.
Yeah, she's happy with the two that she's got. Gives her a tie going into the final end. She's saying, well, you go ahead and hit it, Wayne.
Yeah. Does connect, obviously, the likelihood is he's going to hit if he gets the three balls.
Slightly less pace. Needs to hold up. And on to the jack. No, I didn't see that result, but it was a good result, a good hit as well. Well, she draws to make a one to go into the last end, needing a two.
She needs to run.
Let's just hold her head. Yeah, well played, Katherine.
One shot, Katherine Rednall.
Set score 5-4 after 8 ends.
Yet again, the next set goes all the way to the end.
Jack length 27 metres.
Great start from Katherine. Line again. I think it just needs to run a little bit. Well, how's the pace? It's not too far away. She wants to hold up, I think. Just a couple of balls tight, that was all.
Two green.
Still line two, though. That is enough to force a tie break.
One time out win.
Here. Yeah.
Down to the jack, I think. Well, that was a fantastic bowl from Wayne. Front edge of the bowl is slightly shorter than Jack. That might just cause a slight issue for Katherine. Remember, she needs to score a two after this bowl. So, just a slight touch on the jack. Wide enough. She's not wide enough. I think she's just undercut this.
Yes, she has.
Yeah, she has. So it's going to be one to Wayne Willgress, and he's going to take this second set. Six shots to four. Well, what a fabulous display of bowls there from both players. Katherine Rednall showing that the lady players can certainly compete with the men at top level. But it's Wayne that will see himself into the second round. Well, let's have a look what we have coming up for you tomorrow. Don't forget, we have a 9:30 start again tomorrow. It's going to be England's Robert Paxton taking on the Israelis' Noam Yehudai. 11:15, Darren Bennett takes on the New Zealand player of Colin Rogan. And then the first game for you in the afternoon at 2 o'clock is Greg Harlow taking on Jamie Walker. Well, I'm afraid that's all we have time for you today at Potter's Resort. So until tomorrow, it's a very good night. God bless everybody. Bye-bye.